One of the biggest players, both literally and figuratively, in NBA history, Zion Williamson has finally made his comeback to the world of basketball after missing out on almost 2 years' worth of games. Now that the Beast has completely recovered from his broken foot, which had kept him sidelined for the entire 2021-22 NBA season, he's ready to step back onto the court. Here's what we know so far, starting with Guess Who's Back? Williamson was setting up to be the next big thing for the NBA before making his presence in the league. Fans were excited to see him dominate the courts even before he had played a single game. However, the former number one pick's NBA career has been far from ideal so far. He might have shown some signs of stardom every now and then, but due to constantly getting injured on and off the court, Zion has yet to show off his full power. But now it looks like that's all going to change in the upcoming NBA season, as Williamson seems hungrier than ever for success. Moreover, even his trainer has claimed that he's been busy putting in work and has managed to become even more athletic ahead of the season. During a press conference at the NBA Media Day, Williamson was asked how he felt after his complete makeover, and the 22-year-old joyfully replied that he was feeling great. This is good news for fans of the New Orleans Pelicans, as they've been waiting to see Zion at his best for the last few years now. Let's take a look at Williamson's new physique. Even a quick look at Zion once during the NBA Media Day would have been enough for you to know that something has changed in the past year. The star looks much leaner and in better shape than he had during last year's media day. After seeing his before and after pictures, fans couldn't help reacting to the tweet. Most of them were glad to see that Zion had finally decided to get into shape, believing that if he manages to stay the same way throughout the season, he may very well take the Pelicans deep into the league this season. Meanwhile, some fans aren't impressed and claim that he didn't look that much different from last season. But to be fair, whichever side you believe in, we'll still only find out about his improvement once the new season begins and we get to see him in action. What's more, his new body spells trouble for the entire league. Although Williamson has only played 85 games in his NBA career, he's already managed to make a name for himself as one of the best dunkers in the league. Not many players in the league have the power or flight like Zion does, and none of them is his size either. His iconic double jump technique, which was the subject of studies at Duke, was already a devastating move since Zion could grab his own misses before any of the defenders could even get off the ground. And now that he's in much better shape, Zion claims that he's both faster and also jumps higher. Hold on a second, did you say jumping higher? Yes, you heard us right. If Zion's actually moving and jumping according to how he claims to be, then he's going to be nearly impossible to stop than he already is. He also believes that his commitment to his body is paying off and is allowing him to do things that weren't physically possible for him to do in the past. While it's not as if Zion has suddenly gained his superhuman physique overnight, though that would explain a lot, staying in shape and working out in consideration will hopefully reduce the chances of him getting injured and allow him to improve on the things he's already good at. Pelican fans are definitely in for a treat this season, and if Zion can stay healthy, we might even see him make a run for the MVP crown. Furthermore, Williamson also credited his improvement to music from Notorious B.I.G. A lot of NBA players who are still drawing checks from their rookie deals tend to listen to more modern artists such as Drake or Future. Even Herb Jones shared that he had both artists on his playlist, alongside a few tracks from Gunna and Meek Mill. However, Williamson went back to the classics, ending his media day conference with a story about being inspired by the Notorious B.I.G. According to him, Ready to Die was his go-to album to help get through tough times. It helped change his perspective on how to deal with stress and feeling as if the weight of the whole world was on his shoulders. Williamson explained that the album helped shift his mindset to find true resolve within the game and to recount everything he had been through in the last year and a half. He also mentioned that there were some things that he wished hadn't happened, but the album had taught him that those things were all a part of life. Things are going to happen no matter what you do. You're just going to have to roll with them. Let's take a look at how Williamson stays in shape. Being 6'7" in height with a weight of 285 pounds makes Zion an incredibly heavy player while still not being very tall in the world of basketball. There's no denying that he's a physical wonder while also being the fourth heaviest player in the NBA. However, most of the players around the same weight as him are notably taller than he is. Recovering from breaking his right foot wasn't easy. Most of the players in the same weight category as him tend to take on a few pounds when out of action, which makes it a lot harder for them to return and get back into shape. However, Williamson's trainer, Jasper Bibbs, was in charge of ensuring that didn't happen, and he explained the process of bringing the beast back to his best, and then even further beyond. His ultimate goal was to make him more resilient and efficient, and to allow him to perform at high levels while still managing to stay healthy throughout all of the struggles of a full season as well as the postseason. Bibbs came up with and committed to a plan over the summer. He didn't want Zion to just have a great season, but to also focus on how to help his team win games. To that extent, Williamson had to become tougher and be better at handling the demands of being an active player of his size. There was also a lot of focus on aerobic and anaerobic conditioning. Now, seeing him at the NBA Media Day at peak physique, it's obvious that the strict workout regime has worked out perfectly for him. Meanwhile, in other NBA-related news, first up, Lonzo Ball can't run or jump without pain as his second knee surgery of the year approaches. After having spent the summer in rehab and seeking opinions from different knee specialists, Lonzo Ball, the Chicago Bulls guard, said that he still couldn't run or jump without feeling a sharp pain in his left knee. He's scheduled to undergo another arthroscopic surgery to deal with whatever was causing the pain. Although the Bulls said that Ball's position had been scheduled to be reevaluated in the weeks following his surgery, both the team and Ball himself hesitated to put a fixed date on his return this season. However, Ball doesn't believe that his knee will cause him to miss the entire season, and we sure hope that's the case. Next up, LeBron James invests in Major League Pickleball. Looks like LeBron James and Maverick Carter are both teaming up to headline a brand new ownership group in the sport of Major League Pickleball. Major League Pickleball is the latest professional team league in the U.S. Recently, it also expanded from 12 teams to 16, giving a lot more opportunities for companies to invest. However, no financial terms of the deal have been disclosed as of yet. And lastly, DeAndre Ayton says he hasn't talked to the team head coach ever since he was benched. Apparently, DeAndre Ayton, center for the Phoenix Suns, has admitted that he hasn't spoken with Monty Williams, the head coach, ever since he had been benched during a Game 7 loss to the Dallas Mavericks back in May. Talk about holding a grudge, jeez. Ayton had a tense summer with the Suns signing a four-year, $133 million offer sheet with the Indiana Pacers before Phoenix matched using his restricted free agent rights. Ayton worked out at a Suns facility for weeks leading up to training camp, while Williams said he purposely decided to leave players alone a little this summer to give them space. Ayton has been terse in his comments to the media about his feelings over the last 2 days, about how the contract discussions played out. He's made it clear he intends to take a business-like approach to the season and hasn't had his more typical jovial attitude. That's a wrap for this video. What are your thoughts on Williamson's transformation? Do you think he has a shot at MVP? Let us know in the comments below. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. See you in the next one.